Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Dangan Ronpa 2. Trigger, heavy, come on. Now, in the last episode, my hero fucking died, and now I'm depressed. So we gonna find out who the fuck did it, and then kill their ass. I let's do. First, I need to take a look at the Monokuma file. Dead. The victim is Mahiru Koizumi. Estimated time of death is around 3 p.m. The scene of the crime when the body was discovered is inside the beach house at Chandler Beach. The cause of death is a single killing blow to the head with a blunt instrument. There is no other conspicuous external injuries and no trace of foreign substances such as drugs. Around 3 p.m., that's the time Kazuichi and I arrived at the diner. Then, if we had just gone to the beach house instead... No, now's not the time to feel regret. I need to focus on doing as much as I can right now. And then, I'm going to find out the truth behind Mihiro's death. That's the only way the rest of us can survive. Chandru's bullet, Lego. Okay, let's look at the band. According to the Monokuma file, the fatal blow was the death that was dealt to Mihiro with a blunt object. The blunt object, it's this metal bat, right? Huh? This metal bat. It's the same as Twilight Syndrome motor case. Huh? There's a girl named Girl E who was killed in the game during the fourth game. That girl was killed with a blow from the metal bat, just like Mihiro. Did you also play the game, Hajime? Is that why you're curious about the metal bat? Yeah, that's exactly it, but... Did you play it too? Then I'm sure you know this, but... The case this time is strongly connected to Twilight Syndrome murder case, I think. In order to solve the mystery behind Mihiro's death, you should probably need to solve that game's mystery too. But even if you solve the game's mystery, all of the class clues in it were lousy and useless. I mean, it started ambiguously, and it was still ambiguous when it ended. That's because you haven't beat the game. Beaten? I finished the game with the game over, but were you able to beat it? I'm not some grown gamer who only talks about video games you never beat. So what am I supposed to do to actually beat the game? I can't stop thinking about that for some reason. But for now, I should focus on the investigation. It's okay to say that the metal bat is absolutely the murder weapon, right? Makes sense. Okay, let's not talk to people yet. I feel like it makes more sense if we look at stuff. Holy crap. Okay, let's look at the refrigerator. There's a lot of drinks inside the refrigerator, but compared to the last time, I feel like there's less drinks. Did people take a lot of drinks from here? Not only that, the only drinks left in here look either sweetened or colored. They look unhealthy. Trash can. Maybe there's clues inside in the trash can. That's what I thought, but there's only a bunch of empty plastic bottles. I don't see anything that looks like a clue. I guess it's not that easy, huh? Are you sure that's not a clue, Hajime? You just put it in there. What's this? Plus side there? No, that's counting peck. Okay, come here. She's lost all life in her body, as if she's a shell. Is she really the energetic Mihiro I knew? I see her laying in front of me, but I still can't believe it. I can't connect the lifeless body to the high-spirited Mihiro. But if we don't have time to wallow, we don't have time to wallow in sentiment. Okay, let's do this. There's no way I can just stand here. I slapped both my hands onto my cheeks and faced Mihiro's body one more time. Mihiro's leaning against the beach house door that leads to the road. If she leaned onto the door like this, it would have been impossible to open. Maybe Mihiro tried to run away when she was attacked and then tried to crawl to the door. Evidence can be seen on the bloodstains on the floor. They're stroked as if she crawled through them. But she used all her energy to crawl away, leaning against the door and took her last breath. For someone as headstrong as her to run, she must have felt really desperate. Monokuma file number 2. Okay. Let's, look at the bloodstain then. These bloodstains on the floor, and they're streaked as if she's crawled through them. They're probably streaked when Mihiro tried to run away during the attack. So shoes, blah blah blah, just read this. Can I look at... Oh, the mask. There you go. What is this? Is this a mask? Did someone bring this toy to the section of the supermarket? Or maybe party goods? Regardless, why is this even here? Did the killer wear that to conceal their face? No, they totally stand out. I mean, it's such a gaudy mask. A gaudy mask? Huh? That mask! You've seen this? Sunwitch Esperito! It is a super fan anime with a viewership surpassing 90% in my country! An anime that has a viewership of over 90%? Is Sonya's country really alright? Could it be? Was that mask placed next to the body? Yeah, it was. If that's true, could it be? Could it be what? Please give me some time! For reasons unknown, Sonya rushed out of the beach house. What's with her? It looks like she knows something. If that's the case, I shall wait until she decides to talk about it. For Sonya to be so worked up, it must be something big. I wonder what she knows. Let's get that bullet blast. Okay. I want to look straight at the body, please. Yeah, okay. So is that everything I need to do? What about this? The closet's open. The closet door's half open. The last time I came here, that wasn't the case. That's a little suspicious. I should probably investigate here, too. Let's see. This is pretty spacious walk-in closet. But there's so much crap in here, the shelves and floor. But if you think about it that way, it means it's possible for only one person to stay in here. Now, look around. There you are, you bitch! I knew you'd be in here! Yeah, fuck boy.
I've been found. Gotcha.
Alright, now let's actually search. Only three choices. Let's look here. Flotation devices, snorkels, nets, there's also some paint supplies too. There's not much else that would be related to an incident. Okay, over here. There's a lot of stuff jammed onto the shelves, even surfboards in the surfboard case, but they're not put away properly at all. Two boards are stuffed onto one shelf, and some boards haven't been left out of being put in the case. There's also an empty surfboard case as well. Jeez, how careless. Jeez! I'm gonna miss that. I wanna look at that gummy bear on the ground, please. Control stick, if you would be so kind to stop being an asshole. There you go. There's something on the floor. This yellow thing is a gummy candy. Finding candy on the floor in a place like this is certainly clearly unnatural. If it's connected to the incident, did someone drop this while they were inside the closet? And we all know who was eating damn gummy bears before. It was Abi Hiyoko. But would Hiyoko actually kill Mihiru? Would she? That's the question. Now we, I guess, go to the door and then talk to everyone after. So this is the shower room. There's a notice on the door. Judging from the illustration, it looks like it's being repaired or under construction. Something like that. That's right, the shower is being repaired, so water won't come out. But what about the hot water? Well, that's impossible too. If the shower is out of order, then isn't it just a waste of space?
I'm sorry.
Just when I planned to fix it, my magic stick was taken away from me. So now I never got around to fixing it. What the heck? What does your magic stick have to do with repairing? Anyway, it's all Monokuma's fault. Everything is Monokuma's fault. Whoa, your doubtful eyes are telling me you think I'm Monokuma's accomplice. You really must have read my mind. Think what you want of me. I've already given up. But let me tell you this one more time. As long as you guys are together, you should be able to stand up against any kind of despair. I promise I will help you out with that. What help? You're doing the opposite. Oh, well, anyway. Looks like the shower room is definitely out of order. But I guess I should check the inside, too. I'll check after. Chiaki! Sorry. What is this? This is suspicious, I think. Did you find some kind of clue? You know the footprints from earlier? They're in front of the entrance facing the beach, right? Oh, that. Kajime and Kazuichi's footprints show that you guys are the first ones to go inside the beach house. But these footprints are just the opposite. They're coming out of the beach house. Now that you mention it, I thought those footprints were trains too. You did? At first, I tried to go into the beach house from the door facing the road, but it didn't open, so I went around and tried to go into the backside door. You couldn't go inside on the roadside because Mahira's body was blocking it, right? And that's when I noticed the footprints. The footprints leading from the beach house to the tunnel looked like they belonged to one person. Someone's footprints leading out of the beach house, huh? That's definitely suspicious. Now that you mention it, Peko said she went for a little swim, right? Could those footprints be? Unfortunately, I went swimming to scout the first beach. I do not know anything about this beach. Is that really true? But these footprints led straight from the beach house to the tunnel. Since I was swimming at the beach, of course my footprints would lead from the shore to the tunnel. Then whose footprints are these? It is no mistake that they are the killer's footprints, but I have no clue whose they might be. Well, for now, it's obvious that this is the clue, don't you think? Yeah, it's probably an extremely important clue. Footprints on the beach. On the beach, eat, let's go away. Say, what you gonna say? That's weird. What do you mean? Well, I wanted to calm myself a little, so I thought about getting a drink from the refrigerator. When I opened it a few days ago, I'm pretty sure there was a large variety of drinks. Well, I guess I'm just imagining things. I mean, who cares about drinks right now, huh? What are you talking about? Seriously, it's okay. I resolved it on my own, so just drop it. What the heck? You started it. Okay, Peko. I will never forgive killing... Chiaki seems quite different from usual self. She must feel very strongly about killing. It's not just Chiaki. There's no way anyone would forgive something like this. I guess you're right. I guess? My. This is just too weird. Something this weird should only happen in song lyrics. Yeah, okay, you're no help. Let's go inside. Here. I guess I might as well check the inside of the shower room, too. Oh, Akane's here. This is really nice. Really spacious shower room. If it's this huge, you could also use it as a dressing room. But changing in the beach house is forbidden. Jeez! What an unreasonable rule. I guess there's no one in here. I was thinking the killer was hiding in here after they failed to escape. It wouldn't be that easy. There's a window. It's small, but maybe you can crawl out of it somehow. Well, it probably doesn't mean anything if someone can crawl through it. But I can't seem to take my mind off it. However, the ceiling is really high, so that window is almost situated in a very high place. Goddamn, I'm tired. I'm sorry. It's so high that even if I stretched out my hand, I can't reach it. It's probably about 9 feet up. And it's not just that. It's an in-barred window. If that's the case. Yup, it's impossible to go in and out through there. What? Are you still thinking about the window? Yeah, I was thinking the killer might have escaped through there. Alright! I got it! I'll pitch in to help you out! Come on, give me a piggyback ride. I'll check the window for you. Pitch in and help? I feel like I'm the one who's pitching in and helping. If you don't hurry up, I'll punch you! And she's really into this. No matter what I say, it's not gonna matter. Fine, I'll leave it to you. Don't worry, my panties are clean. You see, that's good. I let out a deep sigh, then bent over under the window. Alright! As she shouted, Akane jumped onto my shoulders. Ugh! Ah, yeah.
Hey! Your balance sucks! Make sure your stance is wider!
You're a lot heavier than I expected.
Yeah, because I'm so buff. Like, every time I get a massage, they tell me I'm just a mass of muscles.
A massage, huh? Do you have a trainer or something since you're the ultimate gymnast?
Nah, I don't have a trainer. My stepmom's lovers like to get drunk and give me full body
massage. What the hell? I shouldn't have asked.
So, how's the window?
See. So that's what happened.
Did you find anything?
Well, since there's this iron bar, I was pretty sure no one would be able to get through the window. But check it out.
Check it out? Hold on. I'll give it a try.
With Akane on my shoulders, I craned my neck so high that I started to worry.
Yeah. This iron bar ain't even pinned down. Looks like you can open and close it pretty easy. See? My head can fit through, no problem.
Then, it's not impossible to go in and out of that window?
Yep, yep.
Akane jumped off my shoulders and flashed a wide grin. Isn't this a big discovery? But the problem is, how are they able to reach the window? Even if I jump, I can't really reach it. But if two people were together like us, it wouldn't be a problem, right? If that's the case, it would mean the killer had an accomplice. Accomplice?
Huh?
Sounds like a big word. Is that the name of a kung fu master? But even if there was an accomplice, the person acting as the step soul would still be inside. But if you really think about it, just one person could get out of here without help, right? Huh? Really? Yeah, like... A freaking ninja can do it, you know? A ninja can climb fences and walls, no problem, right? Just as I thought. It looks difficult to go in and out through the window. But what the heck? And I even took the time to lend you my wisdom. You're the one who said it was suspicious, so I took time to pitch in and help. It was just a waste of time to help you out. All you saw were my panties. No, I didn't! Oh well, it's not like it's the end of the world. I'm telling you, I didn't look at them! God damn. What do we assume that? I guess that's pretty much everything I noticed in this shower room. We be out. Oh, there's still not enough. I just found these clues here. I don't have enough to find the truth. Looks like I should try investigating that again to find out why Mihiro got killed. Twilight Syndrome murder case. Girl E was killed in the game by a single blow from the metal bat. Metal bat. That's the same weapon that was used to kill Mihiro. That, there's no way that's just a coincidence, right? In truth, this game stream is a missing link. You know, it's a reoccurring theme for mysteries, right? It's kind of like a hidden connection. A missing link. If that's the killer's motive for the killing this time, then that mystery must be hidden inside that game. Plus, the person who might know about the mystery is standing right next to me. I should ask her about it. Okay, let's go then. Only been 17 minutes. This might be not too long if I can hurry and beat Twilight Syndrome murder case fast. Check it! Hey, Chiaki, I wanted to ask you something. Are you okay right now? Are you done investigating here already? Huh? I think I finished investigating once, though. Through? Then let's go.
Yep.
Go. You wanted to know about Twilight Syndrome, right? Then I think you should actually play it yourself. So, let's go!
Let's go!
Yeah, you're right. While Chiaki leading, with Chiaki leading, I left the beach house.
Okay. Pretty sure that's like the fourth time I've yawned today, or in this video.
And headed over to Jabberwock Park, where that unsettling arcade machine was placed. But I never expected that person to be waiting there. Oh god! Nagito! Why, hello there. Hajime and Chiaki. I'm glad you guys are doing well. Nagito? It feels like it's been a long time since I was able to talk to you two like this. Even though we haven't spoken for just a few days.
Why are you here?
Why?
Well, there's no need to worry about a loser like me. More importantly, did you hear? Apparently Mahiru got killed this time. Jeez, how horrible. She was the heart of our group, always spirited and very eager to talk. For her to be killed, if only I could have taken her place, I would have gladly done it. But still, you guys will be able to shine through this outcome full of despair, right? That's right, no matter how hard the dark despair it is, hope can shine much brighter and stronger. Though I do feel bad for Hiro, this is quite exciting. How will everyone overcome despair this time? Looks like you feel no remorse. Jeez, as usual, he's acting so crazy, he's almost pissing me off. So why are you here? Who told you about Mihiro? You don't have to make it that scary face. I'll tell you, you know. Monami. Yep, it was me. You. Why did you untie Nagito without anyone's permission? Did I do bad? I just wanted everyone to get along and, you know, cooperate. There's no way we'd get along. You already know what kind of guy he is. But fighting among friends is what Monokuma wants you guys to do. Hajime, you should forgive her. Monami is making a valid point, too. You have no right to say that. but now's not the time for friends to fight. There's going to be a class trial for Mahiro, right? That's right, that's why everyone must work together and have Monokuma. Enough. Enough already. Just go away already. Understood. Nagito, you two, hurry up and get lost. Well, I'm a little lonely, but I guess I'll do that. I already saw the true ending of that game, so there's no real reason for me to stay here. True ending. So, although I might be a little late, I too will do some investigating for a while. I will try to be useful in my own way. Who do you want to be useful for, too? The killer or us? Isn't it obvious? I will always be on the side of hope. The more I talk to him, the creepier he gets. The more I listen to him, the more I don't understand him. If he didn't exist, this situation would be a lot easier to deal with. Damn it! Hajime, let's just move on and start the game. You're right. Oh, I have to do it myself? Well, okay then, game. Even if I do play this, I might just get a game over again. Before I start, I just asked Yaki if there's a walkthrough for this game. One second, I'm gonna take a sip of my Pepsi. I'm tricky at food. That's some good shit. Hey, can I ask you something? Is there a walkthrough for this game? I feel like I'm just gonna repeat the second day and fourth day again and then get a game over. So is there like a walkthrough you can tell me about it? When you get a game over, that's the walkthrough. Huh? What do you mean? Do you want me to tell you? I'll tell you if you want. There's a hidden command. A hidden command? You should have seen it too, you know? That thing that was displayed on the game over screen? Is that... Down 3, right? Oh, down 5. Are you talking about the message that says, down 5? Just so you know, that doesn't mean you down 5 drinks or something. It means you have to press press down 5 times. Then the hidden command is... You just have to press the down button 5 times when you're on the title screen. If you do that, you should be able to go to the real game. So that's the trick. Just expect it as the ultimate gamer. It doesn't have anything to do with being a gamer. This is just, you either get it or you don't. Oh wait, what the hell did I get to Twitter? In fact, Nagito got on his own, so it looks like he managed to beat the game. Come on, give it a try. Yeah, I got it. Let's go. Monokuma Soft. This game is a work of non-fiction. Don't really care, because I already heard this. Oh god, I need to press down 5 times on the title screen. Alright, let's do this. Open the new door to the Twilight Syndrome murder case. Press it down. Please press down 5 times with your own hands. The screen changed. She was right. This is the real game. Twilight Syndrome Murder Case, Truth Edition. I should start it up, but feel I need to find out why this is a motive. It'll start if I press the start button, right? Now then, let us begin Twilight Syndrome Murder Case. Please press the start button with your own hands. We open with a specific murder case, a tragic killing that occurred within the grounds of the academy that the girls attended. Based on their understanding of the crime scene, the police ruled that the incident was the work of a pervert who snuck into the school grounds. However, there was a secret behind the incident. Even before the janitor first discovered the body, there were students who had witnessed the crime itself. The students were 5 high school girls. They didn't want to get involved in the incident, so they tried to hide the fact that they were the first to discover it. However, tragedy befell those girls. Several days after the incident, one of the 5 girls, Girl E, is murdered by someone. What in the world has happened at this once peaceful academy? By playing the missing first day and third day, you'll be able to understand that mystery. All the answers you seek are hidden in the Truth Edition. Will you be able to reach the truth? Reach out to the truth all my life! Let's do this. Now then, let's start with the first day, where it all began. I can hold the X button to speed it up. Very good. Now loading. First day. I'm sorry, I'm really sorry for keeping you all waiting. Jeez, we're gonna go home late because we had to wait for Slowpoke Girl 8. Come on, Girl B, you don't have to be that mad. Hey, don't get to talk anything further without permission. People might mistake us for good friends. I'm not your friend? What? There's no way I'd ever be friends with a nasty, trashy pig shit like you. What? Wait. Ta-da! Ta-ha! That way Girl B treats people, even loan sharks looking to collect would get sick to their stomachs. Huh? Is Girl E here yet? Apparently she forgot something. She told us to wait just a little longer. She can't find her school swimsuit. Her swimsuit, huh? Maybe it got stolen? Stolen? You don't know? A pervert has been spotted in the area recently. Hee-hee, you should be super careful, girl, eh? A chubby weakling like you makes the perfect prey. Hey, stop it, girl, eh? Is getting really scared. Yeah, it's fun to bully, girl, eh? Oh! Well, what was that sound? It sounded like glass breaking. It sounds like it came from the second floor. Let's go! Weird. How does... There you go. Girl B, what happened? I don't know. I walked right in front of the music room just now. And then I suddenly heard the sound of glass breaking. Is someone in there? That's what I think, but I think the door's locked. I can't get it open. You're right, it's locked. Did someone lock it from the inside? Is someone really in there? If we use the key from the teacher's lounge, we can open this door, right? I'll go to the teacher's lounge to get the key to the music room. The teachers are probably gone by now, so I'm sure we can bring the key over by secret. But I have a bad feeling about this. I found the key. Nobody was there, so it was super easy to get. Then let's open it right away. Great. Okay. Girl A, you lead the way. Huh? Me? Come on, hurry, hurry! Clatter, clatter, clatter. Is there a dead girl? I can't take my eyes off this. Someone's laying on the floor. She's not laying down. She's dead. Dead? That's impossible. Why? What? Just lower your voice. They might still be nearby. Nearby? I mean, this looks like someone murdered her. Murdered her? Seriously, shut up. What's gonna happen if the killer notices us? Well, what should we do? What should we do? I see. So that's what happened. I found it. The killer is these escape route. Escape route? Could it be? Ah, the window to this the window is broken. The sound we heard from the entrance hall was probably the window breaking. Someone probably locked the door, the music door himself from the inside after killing the girl. They broke the window and escaped outside. Oh god. Looks like she got hit by something when she died, but I can't seem to find anything bloody here. What happened to the weapon? Did the killer take it? So the killer just ran out the window? But if they just wanted to run away, they could have opened the window. Why did they have to break it? They were probably trying to leave in a hurry. Look, there's evidence. The fish tank in the window was tripped over, and all the gravel is scattered. They must have accidentally topped it over when they were frantically trying to get away. Broken fish tanks battered to the truth blood section of your handbook. It's not too high to jump from the second floor, so maybe they thought it'd be easier to use the hallway, safer than using the hallway. But is that really it? I mean, to lock the door, you'd have to either lock it from the inside of the music room or use the lounge key. Oh, when I went to get the music room key, it was in the teacher's lounge. So the killer wouldn't have time to return the key before they broke the window. Then the door should have been locked from the inside. That means the killer was inside the music room. Also, to get to the outside room from the music room, they'd need to have passed by us in the entrance hall. But we didn't see anyone pass by. Which means the killer only escape route was the music window. Was this window. There's escape route. It's probably that pervert I heard about. He's the one who snuck inside the school grounds. Huh? My school swimsuit was stolen. I couldn't find it anywhere. Then the pervert who stole girl E's school swimsuit was also murdered that girl over there. They probably locked the music room so they could rape her, but she ended up resisting. So they frantically tried to get away, broke the window, and escaped. Tickle. Isn't it bad if we stay here much longer? I mean, I don't want to get involved in something like this, and the killer might be still around, too. That's bad. Uber bad. We better hurry and run. But don't we have to report this to police? Don't you know that what happens when you report this kind of stuff to the police? You become the prime suspect just because you found the body first. And we definitely don't want that. Yeah, it'd be best if we left this room how we found it. We just locked the door, everything how it was. We're out, I'm out, bye. hey, please wait, don't leave me. Third day. All of a sudden, okay. Girl D! Sorry, did I make you wait? So what's up? You asked me to meet me here. Don't tell me you're gonna confess your love to me. Huh? What happened? I want you to look at this photo. On the day of the incident, I found this when I peeked in the next door classroom as I was going home. And I couldn't help but taking a picture. What do you think about these broken vase pieces mean? That sound we heard from the entrance hall wasn't the sound of a window breaking. What is this? I don't know anything about this vase. And if that's the case, the killer didn't escape from the window. Seriously, I don't know anything. It's okay. I made sure to throw it away. Huh? If anyone found it, you'd be in trouble, right, girlie? Are you trying to blackmail me? Of course not. That's not what this is about. If there's something you're hiding from me, I want you to say it. I mean, we're friends, right? You didn't say anything either. I knew, you know. I knew that girl who you killed was tormenting you. Huh? No, she wasn't just tormenting you. She was seriously making your life a living hell. That bitch was in her photography club back in middle school, right? She was probably jealous of your talent, so she... I'm supposed to be your best friend. If you told me, none of this would have happened. Girl E, don't tell me you... That bitch thought she could do anything she wanted just because of her family's influence. And I just couldn't stand it anymore. You know, at first I tried to talk to her. But that bitch started talking shit about how she'd target me next time. So I felt a sudden rage, and before I knew it, I was choking her. And then she lost consciousness. Things would have been worse if she woke up, so that's why I had to do something about it. It's not my fault, or yours. It's all her fault. She ran out. Ah, girly! That's an incinerator, and usually those things go straight into there. That bitch. Girlie, was it? Word is she was with her on the day of the incident. Looks like she threw something away here. What was it? What the hell is this photo? This vase is. Could it be the sound of breaking glass was actually this? If it wasn't, why did she try to secretly get rid of this? That bitch! What the hell did she do to my little sister? Looks like I need to ask her a few questions, and if that bitch really did that, I will never forgive her. Wow. Okay. Looks like this is the end. That's it. Right. That's the truth edition. The incident's first day and third day are depicted on it. Okay, yep. Now you build in all four events from the first day and fourth day. Hey, Chiaki, what do you think of the characters in this game? You mean, like, Girl A and Girl B? Their names make no sense, and they have no romantic chemistry either. No, not that. While you were talking, looks like the ending staff credits rolled. Staff roll? You should be able to find out what you want to know if you look at it. Probably. What I want to know was on the staff roll? Producer Monokuma, Director Monokuma, Supervisor Monokuma, Plan Scenario Monokuma, The Program Monokuma, Graphics Monokuma, Sound Monokuma, Cast Sumiki, Koizumi, Hyoko, Miyota, Sato, and Kuzuryu? What? Wait! What? What? And if it's based on actual live events, all of that happened? I kind of assumed this. Let me guess. Okay, so Girl A was probably Mikan, Sumiki. Girl B was probably Yoko. Girl C was probably Ibuki. Girl D was probably Mahiru. Girl E was probably Sato, because we don't know anything about her. Girl, and guy F was probably Fuhiko. But why was there two Kuzuryus? They didn't mention. Fuhiko did mention he had a sister. So that means his sister is dead. Oh my god. Wait, just now! See, didn't I tell you? What you want to know is going to be on there. Yay! Congrats! Miracle, congratulations! You have finally beaten Twilight Syndrome Murder Case. Now that you guys have played the game through the end, you should already know. That's right, this game is non-fiction game based on actual past events. Is that true? By the way, non-fiction means an original story based on historical facts or records. Hey, answer my question. But even if this is non-fiction, you guys probably don't remember it. Well, that can't be helped. That school life that you no longer remember is the setting for this story. Our school life. At any rate, congratulations! Now then, as for the ending prize that I'm supposed to give you as a reward for clearing the game, I won't give it to ya! Ending prize? There was only one ending prize, and I already gave it to the first person who beat it. So, how disappointing. Did you say ending prize? Like, I was told the same thing when I beat it too. Man, I was too late. If I had known something like this was gonna happen, I would have played the game sooner. That's totally what Fuhiko is holding, which means he beat it first. But the ending prize isn't the problem. It's what Monokuma said earlier. He mentioned how he used our school life as the setting of the game. Just as I thought, so it's so connected at this time too. But is it really true? If we're already living our school lives and our memories were completely taken, is something like that crazy actually possible? Then what did they do to us? Looks like there's something on your mind. Huh? Monokuma probably said the same thing to everyone else who's beaten the game. That game is non-fiction. That it's the missing link that existed in our forgotten school memory. So do you believe it? Do you really believe our memories were taken? I don't know, but instead of thinking about what's right now, about that right now, we should focus on solving this mystery first. Whatever we believe its motive or not, it's clear that the murder did occur. If that's the case, then I need to question them directly. If I do that, I might be able to learn something. You're talking about the people whose characters appear in the game, right? Then I'll go too. That's right. If I get some information from them, I might find out about something. About the mysteries behind Mihiro's death, and about whether this game is true or not. And if we really had our memories taken away. Then let's hurry and ask the others. And while you're at it, ask them how it feels to be characters in-game. Also, if you want to gather your thoughts about the creative content of the game, talk to me anytime. I see. Thanks. That's a huge help. I don't know where they are right now, but we won't learn anything if we just stand here. Alright, let's go. Why, hello there, Hajime and Jackie. We meet again. The timing's too perfect. You were waiting here, weren't you? Ah, so you caught me. Wouldn't it be best if we traveled together? If you'd be in the game, we must think similarly, right? No, maybe I'm being a little too conceited. A guy like me thinks similarly to you guys. It's okay, just make your point. Well, there was an airport on the first island, right? I told them to meet up there. Then, why, the characters who appeared in the Twilight Zone murder case, of course. The girls must be busy with their investigations, too. It'd be a waste of time if we both questioned them, though. If you want to hear what they have to say, you should come with me. I'll go ahead and wait for you guys. What should we do? I guess there's only one thing we can do. I guess you're right. Let us go yonder to, Fuckboy! Told us to meet him there, so we gotta go from here. Let us go! Oh boy, this is kinda slow. I'm surprised, this is taking much longer than before. I thought it would. It's already been 41 minutes. Let us quickly check the, pet. How you doing? All good? Good. Let's go. Hajime, over here! Mikanibuki and Hyoko are all here. The name on the staff roll for Twilight Zone murder case were Sumiki, Koizumi, Sayonji, Miyoda, Sato, Kuzuri. I really wanted Fuhiko to come too, but he locked himself in his cottage and won't come out for me. So unfortunately, he's absent. It's probably because I'm so incompetent. I apologize. It's okay to be absent? I thought you said we'd get executed if we didn't come. Executed? I mean, you said Monokuma had something important to tell us, right? We came because you told us that. Sorry, that was all a lie. a lie? you tricked us. What the heck? Fine, then I'm leaving. Can you wait until we finish our business with you? Right, Hajime? This is like I'm on the same team as Nagito. No, I can't focus on that right now. I have to get the information from them. Okay, we'll start with Hyoko. Because you were good friends with, what was the name? Mihiro. Yes, there you go. I can't believe you actually tricked us so we come to this place. I have nothing to say to impudent, regular people like you. Regular, huh? She's right that I might be a regular guy, but I also have an ultimate talent, or at least I should have one. What? Do I have to talk with you first, then? The name of the Stepper are blah blah blah, okay. Jeez. So I guess we have to start with Ibuki, then. Didn't want to look at the back there. Oh, no, Chiaki's here. I guess I don't talk to Chiaki, though. That doesn't make sense. Damn it. Hey. There you go. Hey, Ibuki, can I ask you something? Bring it on! Have you played Twilight Central Murder Case? Well, that's a computer game, right? I'm basically offered at those things. Ibuki's a tough girl, so I don't touch anything powered by electricity except electric guitars! I'm pretty sure that's a lie, but now's not the time to really dwell on something like that. Her unique tone and hyper energy, there was a character like that in the game, too. Let me ask one more thing. What's the relationship between you and Mihiro? You mean that in a perverted way? No, in a normal way. Well, even if you ask me that, Ibuki's encounter with Mihiro was... when I asked Mihiro this morning to go to the beach with us, she made this real disappointed face. A disappointing face? Yeah, but disappointment varies depending on the person. Ibuki associates it with the department store rooftop. Let's just stay focused on Mihiro. It turns out Mihiro had some business to do, business too, and she wanted to invite me there instead. Wait, are her hands behind her back? Yeah, they are. That's kawaii. She said something like, I was thinking about meeting with everyone, but if you already have plans, do you know what she meant by everyone? Nope, I didn't ask.
Aww.
I see. And Mahiro invited Ibuki, but why? There you go. Mikan! Hey, do you have a minute? There's something I want to ask you. Have you played Twilight Sooner Murder Case, Mikan? No, since we said we weren't going to play that game. Also, I'm not very good at video games. I'm pretty slow and I panic instantly. For timid tone, I'm pretty sure that girl A character was like that too. Anyway, can you tell me about your relationship with Mahiru? Relationship with Mahiru? I first met her when we first gathered at the classroom with everyone else. And after arriving at the island, I did a few conversations with her, but... Oh, could it be? Did Mahiru hate me? No, that's definitely it. She hated me. She doesn't know anything. It's more like she doesn't remember anything. But even though she hated me for her to actually invite me, she must have been a really kind person. Invite? Mahiru invited me this morning. This morning? She looked very serious, and she was wondering if we could all meet up so she could discuss something. But I already had plans to go to the beach, so I had to decline because I needed to prepare for that. And when I did, she made this lonely face and said that she'd reschedule for another day. But if only I went with her, this wouldn't have happened. Mahiru invited Mikan? Why? Yeah, she definitely played the game. I see. Looks like we have obtained some pretty valuable testimonies. Based on that, it seems like Mahiru also beat that game. Why do you know that? If she hadn't, she wouldn't have chosen these people to talk to. Because she beat the game, she talked to the people who appear in that game. Just like what we're doing right now. But in her case, it was much more serious. Probably. I mean, she was forced to learn that she was involved in that game. That's true. But I'm surprised, I never thought Mira would play that game. It's true, that was unexpected. Nagito, did you tempt her into playing that game? Huh? What? Huh? I remember. Anyway, what happened to Mahiru? Did she leave saying she had some business to take care of? Huh? Why do you know that? Wait, you tempted her, right? Just like you did to me? Tempt? That's a rude thing to say. That's disrespectful towards Mahiru. There's no way her feelings would change just because a useless guy like me tempted her. At that time, she was already considering giving that game a try. All I did was give her a little push. That's all it was!
It's obvious.
What the heck? But more importantly, isn't it better if we just listen to what she has to say? She's being quiet as ever. I'm counting on you, Yoko. If Mihiro spoke to everyone who appeared in the game, she should have talked to you too, right? Well, Yoko? She never talked to me at all! Oh man, what a surprise, I didn't expect you to ask me such an easy question. So I'm just gonna go back to my cottage now. Hey, Yoko! Ignoring my voice, Yoko ran away as though she was avoiding me. Looks like it's okay to say she ran away. Clearly, she's clearly suspicious. That's pretty much decided. Regardless, it looks like we finished here, so why don't we part ways for now? There's still something I need to investigate. I'll see you again later.
Bye now.
Hey! What the heck is his problem? Even his exit was pushy. Chiaki, what should we do? Should we go back to the scene of the crime one more time and investigate? It's very important to investigate the scene of the crime, but let's go over to Mahiro's cottage first. Mahiro's cottage? If she beat that game, it's better if we investigate there, I think. She might have that. Oh, the ending prize. If that's the case, I'll go with you. You're okay with that, right? That's your cue to say yes. Okay. To Mihiro's cottage then, my good sirs! God dang. I can't believe Mihiro's dead! The one girl I wanted to live! She got wrecked too, straight to the freaking homer. Right in the head, baseball bat. Is that Vico? Yeah, it is. Okay. Miss Jackie? Okay, so there's gonna be a Monokuma plushie in here. The door looks unlocked. Moving after you're told to be two-thirds rate, so I made sure to be the one step ahead. However, room living what's inside is a huge no-no. There are others who want to investigate too. I guess I should go inside. Compared to my room, the cottage had a somewhat pleasant smell wafting through the room. That proves Mihiro was here. But she's not coming back. Then I should try to look for a naughty book. Why? Now, I was only kidding. Kidding, are you that kind of person? Jeez, well, at least I don't feel nervous anymore. Wait, could that be the reason she said that? But it looks like we don't need to search for it. Check out that thing on the top of the bed. On the top of the bed? Sorry, I don't have time for it. I gotta find the Monokuma plushie. There you are, dick. That's all five for this chapter, buddy. There you go. Okay. I'm trying to Chiake. Solid. Envelope. There's an envelope on the top of the bed. Could it be? This might be it. The ending prize Monokuma gave to the first person to beat the game. What's inside this envelope? Let's find out. I turned over the envelope and what came falling out was a few photos. Ah, this photo.
Wait, what the fuck?
Huh? This is a photo of Mikan, Ibuki, and Hyoko in what appears to be some sort of entrance hall. It's just like that game. There was a similar scenario on the first day in the Twilight Syndrome. Twilight's first two editions. Girl B was in a bad mood because Girl A was late, and Girl B tried to cheer her up by taking her picture. Is this the photo she took? Look at this photo too.
The broken vase.
Is that the same photo Girl D showed Girl E on the second day or third day? As I recall, broken vase was in the classroom to the music room. Broken vase photo. Should be one more photo. But this photo is more shocking. As Chiaki showed the photo to me, I was stunned into silence. Holy crap. There's blood coming out of her mouth and her head. And she's hot. She's bleeding everywhere. But she's hot. You know, you'd imagine her hair, like, she'd have a lot more blood around her if she was dead coming out of her mouth and her head. This is an actual photo of a dead body. Since there's a piano behind the body, it looks like this is the music room. If that's the case, could this be the photo of the first victim? Now, wait just a moment. Quick thing. If this is the music room, and they had stated it was on the second floor, this can't be Hope Speak Academy, can it? Because the thing is, if this is Hope Speak Academy, why is the music room on the second floor, if I'm correct about what they're talking about? If I actually saw it saying on the second floor, maybe it's crazy. Because in Dangan Ronpa the original, number one, I'm pretty sure the music room was on the third or fourth floor. So it doesn't make a lot of sense for the music room to be on the second floor when it wasn't there before. You mean it's the victim of the murder that occurred on the first day? Yeah, the one they blamed on the pervert. I just bit my tongue and now I feel like it's bleeding. And one more, this is the last photo. Oh, and that's Sato. Ugh, this is probably the photo of Girl E after she got killed on the fourth day. Baseball bat. I mean, it nearly matches her body in the game. Yeah, there's no mistake. This is a photo of Girly. With that, we finished looking at all the photos. So based on all these photos, yeah, it seems pretty clear. This is the ending prize. This is the ending prize for beating Twilight. and what's depicted in these photos. It proves that Twilight Sooner murder case is based on an actual murder. Once I can take another sip of my Coke. Or Pepsi, it's Pepsi. I prefer Pepsi. But I like Coke as well. Cool. Does that mean that stuff about our memories being stolen? Huh? What's this? Huh? Is there something else? There's a note inside the envelope. Try playing Twilight Syndrome. After you get a game over, press down 5 times to get the real game. Once you do, you should remember what you all did to my little sister. We'll talk then. This note. Huh. Maybe the first person to beat the game received the ending prize. It wasn't Mahiru. Someone else said this to Mahiru. And that person is going to actually receive the ending prize. Mahiru wasn't just lured there by Nagito. She also received this envelope. And that's why she played the game, right? Then the person who played the game first, this envelope, looks very familiar. And the word sister written in the note. Based on these clues, I can't think of anyone other than him. Fuyuhiko, I'm pretty sure. Yep, I'm glad we came to investigate. Because we did that, we discovered a very important clue. Yeah, I agree. But there's still one thing left. We have to find out who actually killed Mihiru, but there's not much time left. I need to hurry. Hajime and Jackie, what a coincidence! If something happens twice, third time's the charm, or so they say. What a coincidence? Are you a stalker or something? Don't say that! I was just thinking about filling you in on the results of my investigation. Results? Did you find something? I'll let you know if you drop down to your knees and lick my shoes. Huh? Just kidding. I was only joking. It didn't sound like a joke to me. Goddamn, Nagito. You're one of my favorite characters just because of how fucking no shits you give. Well, it's about the footprints. The killer left their footprints in front of the beach house, right? Did you find out whose footprints those are? If you want to know, I highly recommend you come to the beach house with me. With you? Of course, you'll come with me, right? I don't trust him as far as I can throw him, but if I can get a clue... What are you going to do, Chiaki? I'm going to try to talk to Fuyuhiko and see if he can tell me anything. So I'll leave this to you. Yeah, that's definitely a good idea. If someone like me tried to talk to him, it'd be impossible, but it might be different with a girl. Just be careful that he doesn't get rough with you. Guess this is where we part. I'll see you later, Hajime. Huh? Did you actually want her to stay? Actually, what do you mean? Let's go! I'll go ahead to the beach house and wait there. Wow, okay then. Look. Okay, we're going to the beach house, right? Here. Teleport here straight. Nagato! Let's go. Let's try going inside! Nagito?
My...
Whoa, why the hell are you here? Why, hello there, Kazuichi. Hello, thanks for going easy on me earlier. Thanks to you, I was able to walk with just mild bruising. You clearly think like an alter. Oh, this bastard.
What the heck?
You two have arrived at a good time. Big news, I've discovered something very terrible. A terrible discovery? Not only that... I believe it's nothing like Sonya's, but there's something I noticed, too. You too, Mikan? Yup, this is great. Looks like investigation is reaching its boiling point. Okay, let's talk to Mikan first. Mikan, you had something to say, too, right? Well, compared to the others, what I have to say isn't that important, so please don't get your hopes up and be disappointed. I get it, so just get on with it. I tried my best to perform the autopsy, and I was able to find out. My hero was definitely killed by the blow to the head. She was probably struck from behind in one blow. Based on the scar, the weapon is clearly the metal bat. But every dark cloud has a silver lining, as they say, it looks like Mahiro didn't suffer. What does that mean? Well, there's no doubt that she died instantly. Her death was instant? That sounds a little strange. I think I better remember that. Mikan's autopsy report has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. And there's another thing I found out. I'm sorry I started talking my own reasons right now. Just tell me. During the autopsy, I discovered this in Mahiro's pocket. I was going to tell you in person, but I couldn't find you, so I put this in your mailbox. About what we discussed earlier, is it okay if we change the place and time? I want you to come to the beach house on the second island at 2:30 p.m. It seems there's someone who wants to interfere with our meeting. Let's keep it a secret. Until then, let's try not to see each other for a while. It would be bad if they started suspecting us for no reason. Hyoko Sayonji. This letter. If the letter is real, it would mean Hyoko met up with Mahiro, right? Plus, Mahiro's estimated time of death was around 3 p.m., and they met 30 minutes prior. If we think about what that implies, then... Oh, I'm starting to get confused! If that's true, what does it mean? What happened between Mahiro and Hyoko? Oh, yeah. Thanks. Okay. What do you want, Sonya? Listen, I have big news! Huge, huge news! What is this big news? Remember the sandwich Esperito mask that was next to Mihiro's body? Oh, the mask the killer used to hide their face? No, that is not correct. That mask was not just used to hide their face. Then what was it for? Sparkling Justice! Sparkling Justice is a serial killer and self-professed ally of Justice whom's name Malins or makes mankind shudder. They wear a hero mask at all times. Supposedly they are a serial killer who only murders other criminals. Do not look so disappointed, Hajime. You need to be surprised. The Sparkling Justice character. That is the serial killer you were talking about before, right? It's true that the mask we found is a hero's mask, but... It is a heroine mask, to be precise. Sunwitch Esperito is a pretty witch girl. See, a heroine. Anyway, so you're saying it's possible that the serial killer is the one who killed Mahiro? Which means there's a serial killer hiding among us? What is this, Dangan Ronpa 1? I'm pretty sure I've seen a dress like this in some other video game. Lo! Spike Chunsoft, get your game shit right, come on. This is stupid. Serial killer my ass. The killer just used it to cover their face. But even so, they sure chose something that stands out. That might be true, but... Although it's easy to write this off as foolish, it might be best if we exercise some caution. Sonya, can you tell me everything you know about this so-called Sparkling Justice?
As the light of justice shines upon my mask, I expose the hearts of malevolent evil.
The hell?
Justice complete! The center of justice that is pierced by justice! The lead star of justice that shines
what the
in
hell?
The sky! That would be me! Sparkling Justice!
What the heck was that? That is Sparkling Justice's catchphrase. An unknown serial killer has a catchphrase? I read it in a magazine in the library. There has only ever been one person, a journalist, who was interviewed Sparkling Justice. The article was written in their native language, so I tried to translate it. However, in the end, the journalist was punished by Sparkling Justice, too. No good can come from getting involved with a serial killer. The serial killer might not want to hear that from you. This is all I know about Sparkling Justice. Thanks to the masks, nobody knows their true age or gender, making them a very mysterious individual. Hey, isn't that kind of a stretch to say that they're a serial killer hiding in our group? No, it does not mean they are in our group. It's possible the serial killer was lurking on this island all along before they decided to murder Mahiro. That's probably not possible. But that's the only thing I can think of. I mean, no matter how much I think about it, I simply cannot believe it. That one of us is capable of committing such a horrible murder. Okay, you know what? Bitch, grow up, okay? The world is fucked, right? It's highly unlikely that there's a serial killer hiding on this island. Yeah, come on, girl. Grow up. Hey, tell me what you know already. Didn't you find out whose footprints those were? Actually, how were you able to find that out? After listening to everyone's story at the airport, I went to a certain place. Well, it's probably better to say I snuck in. To everyone's cottages! Everyone's cottages? I told Monokuma I needed access for the investigation, so he simply let me in. That bastard, he did something shady again. Why did I do something like that? Well, I'll explain my reasoning to you. Nagato squatted down near the entrance to the beach house and began to spread some papers he was holding. Come on, Hajime, take a look. After all, I went to the trouble of gathering all these. Those footprints. I see, so the reason you stuck inside everyone's cottages was... That's right, I wanted to get a sample of everyone's footprints. But unfortunately, Fujihiko wouldn't leave his cottage, so I couldn't complete it. Well, I guess it's no big deal. It seems obvious the footprints belong to this person. Whose footprints are there? Yoko Sayonji. Yoko's? To be honest, the reason I summoned her to the airport was so I could lure her out of her cottage. She shut herself inside her cottage, remember? If she stayed in there, I couldn't sneak in. So I figured if I lured her out, she wouldn't be in a hurry to go back to her cottage. They're treating her like a small animal. It was totally worth it. The footprints I collected there were smaller than anyone else's and matched the footprints at the beach house. Yep, there's no mistake. These are Yoko's footprints. Also, it's not like I was stooping around or anything, but I found something really interesting at her cottage. Something interesting? I found a lot of these candies inside her room. There's gummy-flavored candies that come in four different flavors. Strawberry, melon, grape, and orange. Wait, but there's yellow ones there, too. It looks like she got it from the supermarket. Apparently, she really likes this brand of gummies. There should have been other gummy brands, but she only brought home a bunch of these. People are like that sometimes. They'll be able to only eat the same brand, even if it's just potato chips. Well, what's wrong with that? Well, it's not clear if this relates to the incident, but I thought I should tell you just in case. Just in case, coming from this guy, that means it probably greatly relates to the incident. Yaz, it's time for the class trial like I assumed. Finally. It's gonna be hype.
The time for unparalleled hedonism has come to an end. Come, now is the time to fight the decisive battle. The hostility of fresh blood, the insanity of a contest of wits. So meet up in front of Monokuma Rock. Once you're there, please proceed to the underground by taking the elevator located at the secret entrance. I'll see you soon.
Time to find out who the fuck killed my hoe. Once I'm gonna turn the light in my room on.
No.
There you go. Okay. Looks like it's time. I guess the investigation is over. So it's finally starting. The class trial where hopes and the killer's hopes will finally clash. Well, it's alright. Either way, hope will win the end. Now then, let's go prove it. Arr, what's he so excited about? There's no reason to respond to a guy like that. Anyway, we should start heading over. At the trial field where Monokuma is waiting, I have to make my case there. There is no escape. We have no choice but to press forward. Now then, let us go. As we talked amongst ourselves, we left the beach house and Mihiro's body. Okay! Let's end it off here. In the next episode, it's gonna be trial. And I know it's gonna be a long one, because that's Dangan Ronpa and that's how we do things. So thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time. Scuffing Rough Maybe out.